morning, Daz.
Good morning, Rockstar. So I believe you need something from me.
We need to borrow something. Our daddy's going to fit into it, though, but that's the point, I guess. Your man, Keeney.
Okay, I have a few.
The neon green one. The neon green one.
The Borat costume.
The Boran Mankini.
Ah. With pleasure, my brother. With pleasure.
If it's
for Denver, he needs to put one of those protective layers down at the bottom.
No. Yes, got to go our natural, I'm afraid. We all need to see. I mean, I've just paid good money to see this go down. This is going to be entertainment at its best.
Okay, well, I'm just going to take it off now, and I'm going to put it in an envelope. People don't know, I do wear it as underwear. I'm just going to put it in an envelope.
Okay.
There you go. It's going to be on its way to you guys soon.
Brilliant. The nicest thing is I know that it hasn't, since new, ever been in the washing machine, so that's going to be great.
No, it's never been washed.
Denver's going to love it. Okay, Tony, and in that Borat outfit, and we're going to try and do it in the space of the next couple of hours.
Oh, and it's so cold as well, so it's not going to do him any justice. Ach, Hashem.
Ach, Hashem.
Listen, man, yesterday I wasn't on top of my game, I tell you. I made a schoolboy error. Let me explain. There's this lady, Cindy Singleton. She is just arrived back yesterday from the Monaco Grand Prix. Very nice. And one thing that she bought there, she bought 3 Ferrari caps for her and her family. She actually lives in Durban. And she bought these caps, and this is now her pride and joy, because these are the real deal caps. These are not some Hong Kong caps. You know, these are the real deal Ferrari caps. Paid a lot of money for them. So now she arrives in Johannesburg, and then she connects down to Durban. She gets to Durban and discovers that her luggage is not there. So she phones around frantically. They say, look, your luggage is probably in Johannesburg. So she books a ticket, hops on another plane back up to Johannesburg to find her luggage. She's just got to get this luggage. This is the biggest thing in her life right now. She spends 6 hours walking around Johannesburg International Airport trying to find the luggage, asking for help from every department, the baggage, the airline, everybody. And she's pretty much not getting anywhere, so she's really frantic at this stage. And her brother-in-law, Sean, gets in touch with me, explains the whole story, and he emphasizes quite a lot about how serious she is about these Ferrari caps. Now, just listen out for where I made the mistake, because I gave her a call and, was going to give her the bad news.
Because in the bag, she's got all her stuff, as well as 3 Ferrari caps. As we're talking, she's walking around the airport trying to find the bag. Even got somebody from ex-Scotland Yard that will track her case down, the CCTV cameras, where it is, what's happening.
Hello, Cindy speaking.
Hello, Mrs. Singleton.
Yes?
Hi, Mrs. Singleton. My name is Chris. I'm calling you from the airport, the luggage.
Yes?
I've been speaking to Claudia. Okay.
Yes?
I've got some good news and some bad news for you.
Okay, give me the bad news first.
Okay, maybe I should give you the good news.
Okay, give me the good news first.
The good news is that we did locate the footage of the bag. You know, we said we were looking on the CCTV.
Yes.
We did locate it. The bag came about as being suspicious. So the bag was taken away and destroyed.
Sorry, the bag was taken away?
The bag was blown up, ma'am. They suspected there was a bomb in it.
Oh, for God's sake. I'm losing my mind. They thought there was a bomb in the bag, so they destroyed it.
This happens quite frequently here, ma'am. Look, we just blown up someone else's bag, ma'am.
Hey? But there was no metal in the bag. How can they think there was a bomb in there?
But ma'am, you had lotion. And nowadays, lotion, you can make a bomb.
All right, so where does that leave me now without an exploded bag?
But ma'am, to be honest with you here, ma'am, we blew up the wrong bag. It was not supposed to be your bag. Then we just blown up another one. I hope that was the right person's bag.
You know I'm going to kill you. They blew up the wrong bag.
Unfortunately, ma'am.
Jeez, like,
was there anything that's not replaceable in your bag?
Yeah. There were caps that I bought overseas at 30 euros each.
A Ferrari cap?
Yes. How do you know it was a Ferrari cap?
Because you told me, ma'am.
I didn't tell you.
You did, ma'am. No. You said there were three caps you bought overseas.
I didn't tell you that now. I didn't tell you it was a Ferrari cap.
Simpson, you idiot. Cindy, it's Wackhead. Yeah, how you doing?
Wackhead?
Yeah. Yes.
Cindy, I love Wackhead. You, and I'm sure you'll forgive me before yes. your
I'm
birthday in November.
Cindy.
I'm going to kill you. I'm flipping staying here now. I'm not getting on the flight. I'm coming to kill you.
schoolboy error.
I would have said because I've got them. Do you want to buy them back?
I did do that, and then she just kept on going, nup. I know this is a joke now, so I thought, idiot.
Oh, Wackhead, thanks a stack, buddy.
Go, brother. Kiss me.